Hello children, welcome to second term. We'll start with chapter number 23, volume and surface area of cube and cuboid. So let's talk about the terms used in the chapter. First of all, what is volume? Volume is the space occupied by an object is called its volume. The unit of volume is cubic unit. Now coming to area, the surface covered by an object is called its area, and the unit is a square unit. Now what is TSA LSA? TSA stands for total surface area, which can also be written as surface area. LSA stands for lateral surface area or area of four walls. The top is the ceiling, the bottom is the floor, and the four walls is termed as lateral surface area. Now what is a cuboid? Because we have cube and cuboid, so let's talk about what is a cuboid. Any solid figure which is made up of 6 rectangular faces having 12 edges and 8 vertices is called a cuboid. And any solid figure which is made up of 6 square faces, same having 12 edges and 8 vertices, is called a cube. Let's talk about the formulas. Please learn these formulas. Volume. First of all, we'll talk about the formulas of cuboid. Volume is equal to L into B into H, that's length, breadth and height. TSA, that's total surface area, 2 bracket LB, that's length into breadth, plus breadth into height, plus height into length or length into height. You can write anything, bracket closed. Next, LSA, that's lateral surface area or area of the four walls. 2H, that's 2 into height, bracket length plus breadth. Next is diagonal. Diagonal of a cuboid is under root length square plus breadth square plus height square. That's what a cuboid looks like. Now moving on to the formulas of cube. Volume of cube is S cube, that's side cube, which can also be written as E, that's edge cube, or A cube, which is again a term used for side. Cube means multiplying it by itself 3 times. TSA, 6 E square, LSA, 4 E square, and diagonal is under root 3 A, or you can write as under root 3 S, under root 3 E. Again, that's what a cube looks like. Next. Now, so there's one more formula. Volume of material used in a solid. Suppose you want to find out how much material is used in a solid object. External volume minus internal volume of the object. Now we'll start with the exercise. In this exercise, we have questions only 1 to 16. The other questions are reduced. Now starting with question number 1, you have to find the volume. You have to find the total surface area, or you can say surface area, and the figure is a cuboid. I'm doing the second part. The first part is your homework. Length is 4.5 meters, breadth is 3.4 meters, and height is 2.6 meters. What is the volume of cuboid? Please write down the formula. L into B into H. Multiply length, breadth and height. 39.780. Or we can write as 39.78. And the unit is, volume always has a cubic unit. So M cube or cubic meters. Next, coming to TSA, or you can write SA of a cuboid. 2 LB, that's length, breadth, breadth, height and height, length. So 2 length into breadth, breadth into height, height into length. Now this comes as 15.30, 8.84, 11.70, and on adding all this, we get 35.84. 2 multiplied by 35.84 is 71.68 meter square. Question 2 I'm giving you for homework. Please try out the second question yourself, and in case there's any confusion in the question, we'll discuss it in the doubt class. Now moving on to question number 3. In third question, they've given you the volume, they've given you the height, and they're saying that the base is a square. Now, when they say base is a square, it means the length and the breadth both are equal, or side is equal to side. So, first part, you have to find the side of the square base. Apply the formula of area. Area of a square is side into side. Now, here we are talking about the side, that is length and breadth. So side square is equal to volume upon height. Side square is equal to volume divided by height. and you get side square as 256. Now find the square root of 256. That's how we find out the square root. And the square root comes as 16 centimeters. So the side of cuboid is 16 centimeters. So we can say length equals to breadth equals to 16 centimeters. Next, we have to find the second part. We have to find the surface area, or we can say total surface area. It's one and the same thing, of cuboid. Write down the formula. Now putting the values in the formula, that's what we get. And the final answer is 1408 centimeter square. Next, solution number 4. They've given you the dimensions of the room. Children, when they say dimensions of the room, basically they're talking about the length, the breadth and the height. Whatever is the first one, that's the length. Second one is the breadth. And the third one is height, if it's not specified. You have to find the length of the longest rod. Now, length of the longest rod in a cuboidal room, if you want to place a rod, you will be placing it diagonally. So basically, we have to find the diagonal of a cuboid. Write on the formula of diagonal of cuboid, putting the values, squaring them up. That's what we get on squaring, adding all the values. And 650.25, you have to find the square root. That is 25.5 meters. Now, in case anyone has a doubt how to find the square root, I'm using this division method. That please prefer using the division method, making pairs from back, keeping the decimal intact. 2, 2 is 4, 6 minus 4 is 2, doubling the number, that's double of 2 is 4, writing 5 because we write a number and multiply by the same number, we get 2 to 5, on subtracting we get 25, now there is a decimal, put the decimal in the quotient and bring down both the digits together, 2525. Double of 25 is 50. Now with 50, we'll write 5 and also multiply by 5 and we get 2525 as the answer. So no remainder, question finishes here. So the square root is 25.5.